In 1521, Ferdinand Magellan, a Portuguese explorer, arrived in the Philippines, and on his arrival on Cebu Island, he planted a large wooden cross as part of a ceremony to proclaim sovereignty and to spread Christianity. Leaving Cebu City and heading north along the east coast, all kinds of activities take place on the street, even a serious game of chess. In the early mornings, there are many scholars using the public transport to get to school. This was actually the entrance to a resort, and they wanted to charge me a crazy price for one night accommodation. No surprises that I did a U-turn and left. At the northern tip of Cebu is the town of Maya. Here I took a boat ride of about 30 minutes to the island of Malapascua. On this island there are only about 6,000 inhabitants. No motor vehicles, only motorcycles, and now a bicycle. I had no pre-booked accommodation and was fortunate enough to find a great resort with friendly owner and staff on the beach. Maneuvering these outrigger boats is no easy task. Every boat or ferry that I've taken, I've had to pay extra for the bicycle, and in this case, also pay for the porters. Here I spent 3 weeks. If you watch to the end of the video, you will see why it was worth the while spending 3 weeks here in paradise. Besides having a chest infection and then a fractured rib, not from cycling but from helping to push a boat. Not the first time that I've had rib injuries, once from water skiing and then again taking part in a mountain bike race at Victoria Falls in Zimbabwe. On my way to North Beach using a Hubble Hubble motorcycle taxi. The resort that I was staying at was having a new boat built. Clearly not the first time these craftsmen have built a boat like this. No drawings or dimensional drawings, just pure skill. While I was still recovering from the chest infection, I did a tour to Calangamon Island. The island and sandbar is located between Leyte and Cebu. These clownfish were being very aggressive. It may be that they had eggs in the anemone. Malapascua Island is well known for the thresher sharks. They spend most of their time in deep waters, but move to shallow waters of Kamut Shoal to visit the cleaning stations. Kamut Shoal is a sunken island. The top is between 12 to 16 meters, then drops off to depths of around 200 meters. Specific cleaner fish are found here, and most of the cleaning is done early in the morning. Aerial view of the island. Myself and two other travelers shared the cost of a fishing boat to take us across to Leyte. See you again soon, Malapascua Beach and Dive Resort.